Visual Service calling Antarctica. I'm Karis Matthews here to welcome you to the Antarctic Midwinter Broadcast. It's a special program of greetings and music for members of the British Antarctic Survey overwintering in the frozen south. It's cold, it's dark, it's even more isolated than the rest of us have been over the past months. But today is a time for celebration. In the Antarctic Midwinter, the glow of the aurora australis is the only light in the sky, but soon the sun will be coming back. So over the next half hour, we'll have music, celebrity guests, and messages for all 35 of you who are stranded in the cold, cold snow.
Yeah, you say cold. Well, it is. It's a bit nipping.
The good weather is going to come again.
And give the penguins my best, won't you? Joining us from Cambridge is Aurelia Reichardt, who spent the winter in Antarctica a couple of years ago, and is manager of the Bonner Marina at the Rothera Research Station. Aurelia, welcome. Tell us, what's so special about June the 21st in Antarctica?
Midwinter celebrations have a very long tradition in the Antarctic, going back to Scott and Shackleton at the beginning of the 20th century. Imagine it's something like Christmas with a family. You know, your weeks of prep and anticipation, intricate and elaborate presents, handmade, we exchange on the day. Of games, that's usually some sort of competitive sporting event like Midwinter Olympics, movies, you know, it wouldn't be Midwinter without the screening of the thing. And then there's massive feasts, you know, following weeks of preparation, the chef creates a delicious gourmet menu. And then the day ends with everyone gathering to listen to this very broadcast and, you know, messages from their loved ones. I still get goosebumps thinking back to my Midwinter celebration.
I'm so jealous. And the day is now. This program is going on now. So I hope you're having a brilliant time, all of you, overwintering in Antarctica. And thanks, Aurelia. And we'll come back to some of the research you do there later. But for now, let's get straight on with the messages from home. And first, we visit the team of eight at King Edward Point. You've cheekily requested more than one song, so we'll try to squeeze and snatches of your most played tracks of the year by the Noisettes. And first, one that had you singing along at a pub quiz, appropriately given the wildlife there, by Seal.
There used to be a grey and tower alone on the sea. You became the light on the dark side of me.
David Reid, King Edward Point. Happy midwinter to you all. Hope the bar is well stocked up and you all have a great week off. To my darling boy, we are so super proud of you, son. I just want you to enjoy every moment. I'm just counting down the days so you can come for a big hug and a kiss that hairy face. Love you loads, golden balls. Mum, Dad, Sarah and Jordan. By the way, two of your plants have died. I blame COVID. Love you.
Hi, Matthew. Mum here. Happy winter solstice. Have a great time. Love you.
Matt, you're an inspiration to us. We love all you're doing and we love you.
Hey, Matt. Miss you. Happy midwinter's eve.
Happy midwinter's eve, Matthew.
See you soon, penguins.
Happy midwinter's, Matt. I hope you're having a fantastic time. We miss you loads.
Happy midwinter's, Matt.
Happy midwinter's, Matt. I hope you have a nice day.
Bringing up the rear, it's Dad here. Have a great winter solstice. Love you and enjoy living your dream.
One cheer for Matthew Marsh, because we haven't got time for three. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Happy midwinter, Uncle Jamie. We recorded you some beautiful singing.
Not like that.
Happy midwinter. Happy midwinter.
What noise does a penguin make, Evie? What noise does Uncle Jamie make?
Happy midwinter, Jamie.
Happy midwinter. And some things I don't have to talk to you about football again. It's been very hard.
Have an amazing day, Jamie. Happy midwinter, Jamie James.
Happy midwinter's day, Joe. Here's a few messages from your friends and family. We're all missing you.
Hiya, Joey. It's your favourite Welshman. Happy midwinter, mate. I hope you're fixing more things in your break and you're living a dream.
Hi, Smelly. We hope you're having a good time and we miss you lots. Georgia can't wait to meet her auntie Jo.
Hi, son. Happy Midwinter's Day. Love you.
Hi, Joe. It's Elliot.
And Mum.
Hope you're doing well, bro. Can't wait to see you when you get home.
See you soon.
Hello, Josephine. Just wanted to check in. Just want to say I miss you. All of you. Hope you're having a good time.
From the top, some checkers in Preston, Manchester, South Africa, oh, in the Australia. The next time that we meet, I'm gonna have a brew.
Hi, Jerry. It's Ali here. Did you know that the letter J is the only letter not to appear on the periodic table? It also was invented in 1524, making it the last letter to be added to the alphabet. Oh, yes, happy midwinter.
Watch you drinking from my whiskey. Now won't you have a double with me? I'm sorry, I'm a little late. I got your message by the way. I'm calling you sick today.
Happy Midwinter's Day, David.
Bro,
Uncle
David. You continue to inspire us with your sense of adventure.
We love you.
Hi, David. I love you and I miss you, and I hope you're having the best time in winter. I miss you heaps.
Messages for Andy Lines wishing you a great Midwinter's Day. We also hope you manage a bit of a celebration for your birthday last week. It's been great seeing the photos and videos that you posted online, and we're looking forward to seeing the full set when you get back. At the time of recording, South Georgia is one of the few places we can visit without having to quarantine on our return. However, TripAdvisor suggests the accommodation is rather spartan and the weather a bit dodgy. So we'll wait to see you on your return. With all the best from Dad, Nick, Jane, Ben and Ellie.
Our best wishes to you all at King Edward Point. And in line with your music request, you also ask for this.
Hello, Midwinterers. This is Lauren the Burn calling from muggy London town. Our bodies are in different places. Our environments are completely the opposite of each other at this time of year. But in this moment, the magic of radio is that our minds are together because we're sharing ideas. So I thought that to wish you a happy midwinter and a continuing safe time wherever you are listening, whatever you're working on, I would read you one of my favourite poems, which is about that idea. This is by Emily Dickinson. The brain is wider than the sky, so put them side by side. The one the other will contain with ease, and you beside. The brain is deeper than the sea, so hold them blue to blue. The one the other will absorb as sponges, buckets do. The brain is just the weight of God, for heft and pound for pound. And they will differ, if they do, as syllable from sound. Happy Midwinter.
That was a lovely poem choice by my Six Music colleague, Lauren Levin. Off the far western end of South Georgia is the UK's smallest research station, Bird Island. Plenty of albatross and seals, and just four intrepid humans. No prizes for guessing why you chose this track from Eels.
'Cause I like birds.
Message for Mark Whiffin.
Hi, Mark.
We hope you're enjoying the work even in cold, short days, and that the gourmet evening meal exceeded expectations.
We have sparrows nesting on our roof again and blackbirds in the hedge. Thomas is hoping to be in Bexhill College in September, and Hector is again falling in the Simon Pond twice.
Love, Mum. And
Dad.
P.S. Your treats have been posted.
Hi, Cody. We're not going to do all that sloppy malarkey stuff. You are indeed truly missed. We would say more by scramble and bottom, but my mum's daily tears probably she pins it to the top. We're super jealous that we aren't there, but we're glad that we don't have to suffer with all that cold. Now, we all have hopes and dreams, and we're so glad that you're fulfilling yours. Now, you might not be able to give the love to us, but we're so glad to see that you're kissing those seal pups and hugging again too. We can't wait to see you again, and we hope that you don't fly back to another country before seeing us all soon. We wish you luck, stay safe, have no accidents, and give those seal pups four kisses.
Send me to bring Bird Island food and chums. One day when the tides have gone, they'll take their leave and go.
Happy Midwinter Sea to Claire, Mark, James and Cody on Bird Island. Lots of love from the steam fields. Cheers!
Happy Midwinter Day, Bird Islanders. Hope you have a super day of fun, frolicking and feasting. Special wishes to JJ. So happy you're happy doing what you're happy doing. I know you don't miss me, but you miss the puppy. To Molly, Fife, Ed, Charlie and I send you lots of love. See you soon, sweetheart.
I can't stand the line at the store. The mean little people are such a bore. But it's alright if you act like a bird. 'Cause I like you.
birds.
Now let's keep the birds in going with a very special guest.
That's a blackbird in midsummer in Kew Gardens, sending you best wishes for you in the middle of your winter. The good weather is going to come again, and with it comes a ship, I'm happy to say, carries my name, and it'll be coming to you in the Antarctic in the next year. And with it comes greetings from all of us for whom you are working so hard. I wish you all the best from everybody in this country. Happy midwinter.
Sir David Attenborough, accompanied by Blackbird. This is the Antarctic Midwinter Broadcast coming to you from the BBC World Service in London. Next, a message from the Director of the British Antarctic Survey, Professor Jane Francis.
I'd like to greet everyone in Antarctica on this really important day. Hello to all our BAS staff, Bird Island, King Edward Point and Rother. And hello to everyone who's in an Antarctic station across the whole continent. It is a really special time in Antarctica, actually, from a scientific point of view. This year we have the COP meeting, and I think all nations now are really beginning to understand that climate change is a really critical focus for us all across the Earth. Antarctica itself plays a critical role in the global climate system. So our scientists are working on the melting of the ice shelves around Antarctica and the changes to the oceans. And in turn, those will affect things like global sea level rise and the change of our climate across the whole planet. Thank you all for doing this amazing work. The experience that you're having in Antarctica, I'm sure, will be a life experience that you'll remember forever. Have a really great day. Stay warm, but most of all, keep safe.
A wonderful message and very important message from Jane Francis, Director of the British Antarctic Survey. Now for a rather different message.
Hello, everyone in the British Antarctic Survey. This is Bill Bailey here speaking to you from Hammersmith in West London on a cold and blustery day in May. Obviously, you're going to say, yeah, you say cold. Well, it is. It's a bit nippy. I hope you're all doing okay and bearing up under these strange and unsettling circumstances. I'll keep sending the messages and the songs down there, building up a few now. I might even get together a Bill Bailey Antarctic Song EP. Anyway, wishing you all the very best and speak soon.
It's hot and wet and muggy in London. Not much of a lark. The pubs are all shut and the restaurants are closed and the theatres are still dark. On the high street as the lockdown unravels, and I can't even go where I want on my travels. At night we stay in and the streets are deserted, and I long for the South Pole. Our lives are inverted. Yes, I long for the bright lights of Antarctica.
Grace,
I don't know, it's not always a walk in the park.
Yeah,
great rhyme.
It's brilliant.
But one day I'll find my way to the bright lights of Antarctica. Ooh, oh, oh, oh. Get your lighters, wave them in the air, get some residual heat. The bright lights of Antarctica. I'll find my way to the bright lights of Antarctica. I'll find my way to the bright lights of Antarctica.
Aww.
Stay strong, everyone. Keep it real. And I'll see you one day.
I'm gobsmacked. I had my lights wrapped. Absolutely brilliant. That was Bob Dylan. Oh, I mean, big Bill Bailey.
musician, comedian and winner of last year's Strictly Come Dancing. That's an anthem. We'll all have to sing it together next year. But for now, we'll go even further south and say hello to the 23 scientists and support staff at Rothera on the Antarctic Peninsula, the largest UK research station. Aurelia, you're a marine biologist studying the weird and wonderful life in the sea. Is there much you can do in winter, though, when the sea is frozen over?
It takes a little bit more preparation than jumping on a boat and going for a dive, but it's definitely possible. So what we do is we use some chainsaws to cut a hole in the ice once we've assessed that it's safe to walk on. Sometimes the ice can be up to a meter or more thick. We put on our dry suits, which are obligatory seal watch, looking for leopard seals, and then, you know, we dive in and go for a swim under the ice.
Can you give us an example of how a leopard seal sings? After Bill Bailey's magical.
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't dare.
No, go on.
I think it's more like a...
When you have that dry suit on and you go swimming in the cold waters, I mean, how does it feel?
Especially in winter when the sea's frozen over, it feels like flying because you've got this grey sky of sea ice above you and all of the small algae, what they call phytoplankton, die down. So the water's like glass and it feels like you're flying above this beautiful, colourful seabed around you. Extraordinary.
We've mentioned leopard seals. What other creatures do you find there?
It's quite a colourful place. You get pink starfish and red sea urchins. There's a snail called sea lemon because it's the size of a lemon and it's bright yellow. we've got sea spiders, which are larger than their tropical counterparts. And then you get some giant isopods, similar to wood lice. And they've got 10 legs and they've got a bit longer armour going on, like a little tank walking about. And you can really understand where the inspiration for, you know, movies like Alien came from when you look at these kinds of creatures.
So you spent time in Antarctica, you've dived below the ice. I wonder what changes you've experienced and how conditions are changing for the animals and plant life that live in Antarctica.
So climate change is affecting Antarctica more than a lot of other places in the world. So once you introduce change, it's more than they have learned to cope with, it's more than they're adapted to. So for them, small temperature changes are already very strong and can have detrimental effects on them. What we experience on station is we see the retreat of one of our local glaciers, which has been monitored over the last 50 years. And if you look at aerial images, you can see how the line of the glacier has been retreating hundreds of meters over the last 50 years.
Thank you for describing that, Aurelia, and for all the work you're all doing in Antarctica. But it's time for some songs and messages for Rothera, and we're going to sample a couple of their music choices from Bill Withers and Javier Rudd. I wonder if you can spot a common theme here.
Ain't no sunshine when she's gone.
This is a message for John Law. Hi Johnny, just wanted to wish you a really happy Midwinter celebration with love from me and your dad, Russ, Rose and Tilly. Take care and see you again next year. Mwah.
Greetings Dr. Clara and fellow Antarctic ice cubes. A brief update from the home planet.
On the negative side, it looks like we will be locked down until the end of time. London traffic has become one solid immovable mass. On the plus side, the pubs are finally open. We miss you and send our love.
Mom
and Dad.
Hi, Jack. Dad here. Mom and I have missed you and hope you are well. Everyone is well here. And Tom, Katie, Olivia and Adam send their love. You should obviously have done a group message, as you are our IT man. That's not happened. Hope you are enjoying the Antarctic winter and getting on with your college. Mum and I love you dearly. The South Pole and back, and hope to see you soon. Love, Dad.
Hi, Andy. This is your mum and
Dad
here, wishing you a very happy midwinter. We are glad you have made it to midwinter this time. You have obviously steered clear of knives and cable ties.
Seriously, son, we're very proud of you and cannot wait to see you early next year. Also, happy birthday for next week, and don't drink too much. Love you, son.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, Dad.
This is the Sam Bowman.
From your girl,
Sarah.
And Lonnie.
The sun is rising.
The ice is melting.
My dad's in a gorilla outfit.
Pointy-Head Luke.
Hello, Ed. Are you there? I just wanted to wish you a great winter solstice celebration. Have a wonderful party and bring on the light. Over and out. Love, Mom.
Les chandelles parlent à JB. Je répète.
Les chandelles parlent à JB.
Petit JB, je répète.
Petit JB.
Les enfants, nous n'avons que 30 secondes.
Je répète, 30 secondes.
Attends, tu peux parler.
Respiration serpent, je répète.
Respiration serpent.
Mais
merde, il reste
des
ondes.
Oui,
les chandelles.
Et JB.
Oh, hello.
Hello. Hello.
Happy Midwinter's Day, Kate, from all of us. Love you lots. Have fun.
Hey, Katie, Steve here. Happy Midwinter. Love you very much and miss you. Hope you're having fun on your trip.
Yeah, we really miss you. And we will talk to you soon.
Wish you all the best.
Hi, Katie, your trip looks epic. I'm missing you and can't wait to meet you somewhere for a nice glass of something.
Bye.
Bye. Hi,
Dad.
Hi, Josh.
Hi, Josh.
We miss you. We have a good time out there.
Come back soon.
Yes, we do.
Don't forget about us.
We miss you. It's all been warm. She's still cuddling.
We haven't lost him just yet.
I've lots of work to do.
Na 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 na.
Bye.
Just to say, we're still missing you.
Hope you enjoy all that lovely snow and that you're not too cold.
Take care.
Love you loads, Mum.
Hi, Luke. It's Erin.
And Alex.
I just want to say how much we miss you and we can't wait to see you. Love you loads.
Are you not here?
Yes, yes.
Next day.
Hello, Luke. We'll be glad to see you when you're home.
There's lots of jobs to do. Love you, Grandma.
Hi, Ma.
Happy Midwinter's Day.
Hope you enjoy your parcel and contributions from the family.
You'll be an uncle by now with the birth of the new arrival.
We are proud of what you achieved learning about the ecosystem in the Great Barrier Reef.
Now Antarctica, gaining new skills and even your cooking.
Look forward to your phone calls and pictures. Keep them coming and get that beard trimmed.
Love you loads.
Mom, Dad, all the family and of course, Maya.
We miss you, Pete. Just let us count the ways. Our fridges may be fuller and our servings slimmer, without a boy to browse the shelves and gaze with wistful sighs. And any thoughts of dinner?
We hold you in the markers of our Cornish year. Your wild, mad posies from the wheaty jungle. The first poor chapel sun and sandy beer. Those growing grandbabies who miss their grunkle.
But in the end, beyond ways measureless to man, we just miss you like a fish without a frying pan.
Cześć Mareczku,
Mareczku.
Cześć kochany.
Ja cię też pozdrawiam serdecznie. No, co tam u ciebie słychać? Zimę masz?
Życzymy tobie przyjemnego spędzenia czasu dalszego.
I wracaj szybko do nas.
No, jak najszybciej, ale to i tak będzie w przyszłym roku.
Pa, kochany.
Kochany Mareczku,
wszystkiego najlepszego. Tęsknię za tobą. Czekam na twój powrót i wszystkiego najlepszego.
Pa, kochanie. Jeszcze raz pa.
Cześć.
This is our message from Matthew Phillips on Rotherock from his nephew Luke from Edinburgh. Hi, Uncle Mav. We want to hear Lady KX. I hear that it is getting very dark and very cold where you are. Just remember, if you go outside, the tauntaun will freeze before you reach the third marker. We all miss you, wolves. And we're looking forward to you coming over for Christmas. Over and out.
Hi, Ryan. I know this message should be about you, but it's my birthday, so happy birthday to me. Woo!
Hi, Ryan. Happy Midsummer's Day. Love you. Miss you lots. Bye.
Happy 21st of June, Ryan. Miss you. Love you.
Enjoy the cold ride. Don't get too good at skiing. Bye.
Ain't no sunshine when she's cold. And this house just ain't no more.
Which way the wind blows,
best day is done.
Message for Neil McLeod at Rotherhaugh from Mum, Dad, Abby, Aaron, Bake and Sammy. Happy midwinter. Have a ball. Hope you have a really good time and a few jams. We are missing our lunches with you, but I'm sure we'll catch up when you come home.
You seem to be having a ball. We're all missing you. Lots of hugs. Take care. Be safe. Look forward to you coming back.
Meanie Moo, how are you? Just wondering how you are. We're all good and doing fine, and Mum's had 130 hours to be gone.
To Maine and everyone down in Antarctica, hope you have a really good fun-packed and boozy celebration for Midwinter's Day.
Lots of love from all of us back here, and a big thank you to Bass for giving Maine the opportunity and adventure of a lifetime. He's living the dream.
Love you, Maynie Moo, from Mum,
Dad, and Mayan.
This message is from Mike Linsell and Rotherhaugh from your friends and family back home. We hope you're well, safe and happy.
We have heard there are some big ladies down there in Antarctica with beautiful black eyes, so we know you're not too lonely.
We're enjoying our summer and hope you're enjoying your midwinter party. Missing you lots. Love from Elizabeth.
And Mum.
Hi Robbie, it's Lorraine here. Happy midwinter. I do envy you being in one of the most beautiful places in the world. Enjoy!
Hi Robbie, hope you're enjoying yourself in sunny Rotherhaugh. Your photos look amazing. You're doing us all proud.
Hi Robbie, can't believe midwinter already.
Keep doing what you're doing, son.
We're so proud of you.
Love you.
Miss you.
Get the beers in.
I love you, my friends. It's got this right to move back.
Hello, lovely Nancy, it's Mum. Hi, Mum, it's Jane.
Happy midwinter day.
And here are some sounds from Wales that you might be missing.
Happy Midwinter's Day, everyone. Our message is for Ryan Cummings. Hi, Ryan. Hope you're having a fantastic day. Love you, mate.
Well, you, Sean. Have a great day.
Hi, Ryan. Hope you're having a good time. See you when you get back.
Happy Midwinter, Ryan. We miss you.
We love you, Uncle Ara. Love you for the Antarctic. I love
Happy Midwinter from all the crazy chambers. We love you.
Happy Midwinter, Mark. I hope you're having a good time in Rotherhaugh. Hopefully you'll bring back McClone safe in one piece.
Happy midwinter, Mark. Hope you're enjoying the skiing and the crevasse work and everything else when it's not too dark.
Midwinter, Mark. Hope you find your penguin.
Miss you, Mark.
Love you. Hope you have a great day.
Follow the sun. Which way the wind blows when this day is done.
But the musical theme, something about sunshine perhaps, and yes, the sun will return in a week or two. The light will shine again in Antarctica. Slowly the days will grow longer, and eventually the UK's newest research ship, the Sir David Attenborough, will arrive at the quayside with a fresh surprise. Meanwhile, here's someone else who appreciates the work you do.
Hi, this is Liz Bonin. I'm a science and natural history broadcaster, and I am in absolute awe of you incredible humans and the work you're doing out there to protect one of the most magnificent wild places on the planet. So I'm wishing you a brilliant midwinter celebration, and I hope the rest of the season goes really well for you. And give the penguins my best, won't you?
Happy midwinter. Oh, yes, and give the penguins my best too. And happy midwinter from me to all 35 of you at UK research stations, everyone else in Antarctica supporting the scientific work of 27 other nations, and to all our listeners in slightly warmer parts of the world. Have a wonderful, wonderful day today. And thank you to our guest, Aurelia Reichert. Thank you, Aurelia.
Thank you. Happy midwinter.
Happy midwinter. And to play us out, yet another sunny choice from the crew at Rotherhaugh, it's by Boney M. Antarctic Midwinter Broadcast is presented by me, Keris Matthews, produced by the great Martin Redfern, and is a Buffin Media production for BBC World Service.